Assalamu alaikum.
Ansam rahmatullah.
This is a question from an anonymous person, and she asked, why did the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam married Aisha? Why did the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam married Aisha at the age of 9, and can one use this example to marry young girls?
Okay, the question of the sister is a very good question, mashallah. The question of the sister is, why did the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, why did he marry Aisha at such a young age? And can we use that as an example for us to marry young girls the same age today? Is that right? So let's answer this question. It's a good question, and it's an easy question. Now, the why of it, nobody knows except Allah, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam never married any woman except it came to him from wahy. What does it mean?
Peace of Christ to all of you. Muhammad, he never married any woman except it is an inspiration from Allah. Look at those perverted people. Marrying 6 years old girl, it was an inspiration from Allah. And nobody knows why the Prophet did marry her, because it is an inspiration from Allah. Do you know what does that mean?
What is wahy? The Prophet never went around looking at women and select this one or select that one or say, yo, check this out.
Yeah, right. Yeah, right. You know, when the Muslims, they say things, it make me really laugh. Muhammad, he did not go around. He did not do anything bad. I mean, you guys are, what do you think? Muhammad, he was looking for girls? Abdul, is that tafsir Jami' li Ahkam al-Quran, where it says your prophet, he went to his own son wife while she is married? Not after divorce, she was married to her husband. When the husband was not home and he flirted with her, it says here, ثم أنه عليه السلام أتى زيدا يوما يطلبه فأبصر زينب قائمة كانت بيضاء جسيمة من أتم نساء قريش فهويها وقال سبحان الله مؤلف القلوب مقلب القلوب فسمعت زينب بالتسبيحة فذكرتها لزيد. Translation: Muhammad, he came to the house of Zainab while the husband was not there, Zayd. He came and he was not there, so he saw Zainab and she was standing, and she was white. Notice here, it's very important that she is white. She was white and big. The Arab, they like big women, and beautiful and big. And she was one of the most beautiful women of the women of Quraysh. فَهَوِيهَا, so he fell in love with her. وقال, and he said, سبحان الله مقلب القلوب, praise be to Allah, the one who made my heart flip for you. The man, if you know, flirting with married women, and this is the Muslim story, by the way, I believe he was having sex with her already. And look at the whore, Zainab, look what she did. فسمعت زينب بالتسبيحة فذكرتها لزيد. Zainab, she heard Muhammad flirting with her, so she told her husband Zayd. So Zayd, he got it. فَفَطِنَ زَيْد. That's what it says in Arabic exactly. فَفَطِنَ زَيْد. Like, uh-oh. Then he went and he said, O Messenger of Allah, let me divorce her. She is so proud. And she hurt me with her tongue. So now Muhammad, look at the hypocrite. He said to him, why? Keep your wife for you. Keep you. An hour ago, he was in the house of the guy, flirting with the wife. And then he said to him, keep your wife for you. And look here, it says, and it's been said that Allah, he sent the wind and lift up the curtain. And Zainab, she was wearing see-through clothes, like, you know, almost naked, mutafaddila, which means she is almost wearing nothing. So Muhammad, he saw her naked. فَرَأَ زَيْنَبْ فَوَقَعَتْ فِي نَفْسِهِ. So he saw Zainab naked, and then, or almost naked, and then he fell into her. And ووقع في نفس زينب أنها وقعت في نفس النبي. And Zainab noticed right away that the Prophet, he want her. You know what I'm talking about. Bing, bing. So she told Zaid, and the guy Zaid, he said to himself, uh-oh, Muhammad, my father, he want her. If I don't divorce her, he will kill me. So he told him, take her. I want to divorce her. And this guy, he's saying to us, the Prophet, don't go around. Hold on. Let me show you about Muhammad. Do he really look around at women or not? The most beautiful. I'm not going to mention how many women he raped. Look at this. Muhammad, he was sitting in the front of his house. And this is sahih. This is not a weak hadith. So a woman, she walked by. Muhammad, he was staring at her ass. Read me carefully. Jabir reported. What he reported? That the Messenger of Allah saw a woman. So he came to his wife. What does that mean? You see, now Zainab, the same woman we were talking about, he was flirting with her while she is married. Now she is in his bed and he is doing the bang bing for her. He saw a woman. What does that mean? He was staring at a woman and she made him horny. They say to us, our Prophet is a decent man. He saw a woman and that woman made him get horny. So he went to Zainab, and Zainab, she was tanning leather. That means she is really working hard to do something very important for the house. And he had sexual intercourse with her. Look at this filthy man. While Jesus says, if you see a woman, she is not yours, it's better to block your eye out, better than all your body go to hellfire. This guy, he claimed to be a prophet of God, and he see a woman, she is not his wife, walking by. He stared at her until he got excited, and then he go to his wife and force her while she is working doing leather tanning to do intercourse with him. And look how evil he is. The women advance. He said after he did have sex with his wife, he came back. Imagine his friends are in front of the house. He left them to have sex. Imagine how savage he is. He have visitors. This is why they are witnessing what happened. The women, she walk by. He left his companions, he went inside the house, he have sex with the women, and then he came back, and now he will speak wisdom because he speak only inspiration. Let us see the inspiration. He said, the woman advances and retires in the shape of the devil. You see, it is the woman who is the devil. It's not him. The woman. Muhammad is a victim. And look what he is advising them. When one of you sees a woman, he should come to his wife and do bang bang and reveal his the feeling in his heart. What feeling in his heart? Doesn't say really. What is fi nafsihi, which means his desire, sexual desire. What kind of a great example this man is. And this man is saying us that Muhammad did not go around looking for women, and he did not really favor women in certain way, not because they are children. Let us continue with this idiot who's trying to make a perverted sex maniac, child molester, legal what he did. Listen to this.
Tell a girl, I like to marry him or marry her. No.
No.
Hey. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, the messenger of Allah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, never spoke anything from himself.
Never.
But whatsoever he heard from Wahi, this is what he did.
Absolutely.
Now we know that the Prophet is a man like everybody else, but Allah subdued his nafs. Allah subdued his nafs with wahi, revelation. So he was guided by Allah. He was accompanied by Jibreel, alayhi salam.
He was accompanied by Jibreel.
His nafs never came up above the revelation.
No, never.
So whatever the Prophet selected to do, he did it through the influence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala,
through
the guidance he received from Jibreel, alayhi salam.
It's Jibreel.
So why he got Aisha, we don't know that, because where did the order come from?
From Allah.
Hello.
Hello. What a donkey. Let us read together. Muhammad, he is not a perverted man who like to have sex with the children. No, 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 no. Read with me, my friend. This is a story. This is Sahih Muslim. This is Sahih al-Bukhari. You can read the story from whatever you wish. All right? a man, his name, as you see in the screen, Abdullah. Sorry, Jabir, he report about what Abdullah, his brother, he died. And he left behind him 9 or 7 daughters. This man, he died and he have 7 daughters. All of them, they are very young. They are children. I married a woman who had previously married. Allah messenger said to me, Jabir, have you married? I said, yes. Again, he said, a virgin or a one previously married? What? What's your business? I mean, what is that question? Why Muhammad is asking, describe for me the vagina of your wife. Is her vagina a virgin vagina or not a virgin vagina? Because that's what the question means. What is the business of man to ask you about the situation of your wife vagina? Don't you see this is disgusting? Then he continued, I said, O Messenger of Allah, would one which previously married, and look, Muhammad, the perverted man, he said, why don't you marry a young girl so that she could sport with her, you could sport with her, and she could sport with you. You see, he told us that everything Muhammad, he said, is inspiration from God. It's God, God. This is God talking, guys. This is God. God is making a man who is happily married to a woman think about divorcing this woman or get rid of her or marry someone in the top of her just because Muhammad, he liked to sport with little young girls. I mean, do you know what are you missing? What is the purpose of Muhammad is asking him to do that? What is the wisdom behind that? It's just to sport with the girl. That's all. To get married from a woman, she is smarter. She do more of housekeeping. No, it's the opposite. He's asking him to marry a child. And the purpose is to sport with her. When Muhammad, he gave this advice, this is mean, this is what he like. This is mean when Muhammad, he married Khadija, the woman, she is 20, 25 years older than him. He did not marry her for she was a good woman. He married her because she is rich. She was one of the richest person in Quraysh between men and men or women. It's amazing how they say and how they lie. They make Muhammad as God. Everything he do is from God. This man, he don't do anything for his testicles. It is God. It is Jibreel. He was inspired. And look what Muhammad continues saying. Why you don't marry a child for the purpose of a sport? Muhammad is a sport guy. He liked them young, very young. Because young, whatever we do with them, they will not complain. Give them candy, they will be happy. They will not complain, they are not mature. So we can do whatever we want with them. And they will not notice that you are an idiot or you are a criminal. So you could sport with her and she could amuse. You could amuse with her and she could amuse with you. That is the wisdom of God. And look what Abdullah or this guy Jabir, he said. I said to him, well, Abdullah died. He failed the murder. He was doing jihad for Muhammad. And he left 9-7 daughters behind him. Therefore, I did not approve the idea of should bring in a girl like them, a child like them. So I prefer to bring a woman. What is the dignity of any human being can believe and accept such a thing? This is what God teach. I go to a man and make him hate his wife, and the man he marry a woman to take care of the children, the orphans. And the prophet is seducing the man to go and find a child in the top of the 9 children already he have from his brother. All of this because he want the man to be amused with the child. What is the dignity? What is the honor? What is the ethic? What's wrong with those people? What if this idiot, his daughter, she is married to somebody? And then Muhammad, he came to that body and he said to him, why you marry the daughter of this guy? Why? Why? Are you stupid? Is she young? No, she is previously married. Why you do that? Leave the daughter of this guy and go and find a young girl so she can amuse you. And you can amuse her. And she can sport with you. And you can sport with her. This is how perverted they are. Defending such an idiot criminal. You see, the second you look at this guy, look like he's possessed. He is defending with no honor. Are you really convinced with this garbage that Jibreel told him, Allah told him? The girl, she is 6 years on the Islamic calendar, which means she is 5 years in our calendar. The girl, she was playing with her toys, and there's tons of hadith. The girl is just a little tiny girl. Go and search if you don't know what 6 years old girl. And he says that this was a tradition in the time of the Arab. I am an Arab. This is a big fat lie. This is a big fat lie. I challenge this coward to show me one Arab person he married at that age. And this is why Abu Bakr, he said to him, but you are my brother. And then this guy, he said, Abu Bakr, he's trying to get rid of this perverted man, but he don't dare. He will kill him. So this guy, he said, Abu Bakr said to him, but you are my brother. And then Muhammad, he said, yeah, but we are not that kind of a brother, and she is mine. What a sick religion. What a disgusting cult. What a filthy, if this is God, if this is, listen, if this is really what God told Muhammad, that means your God is the devil.